India is vibrant and unstoppable. Our roads bridge its diversity and bring our people together. Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee envisioned a connected India. In 2001, he started the National Highways Development Project to connect the four biggest metro cities known as the Golden Quadrilateral. India is now connected with the world's second largest road network of 48 lakh kilometers. The vision to connect India is carried forward by the North-South-East-West Corridor, the SARDP-NE for the northeastern regions, and the LWE Road Development Project for left-wing extremist areas. A new company, NHIDCL, has been formed to focus on highway development to promote connectivity with neighboring countries and roads in border and remote areas. In the past few years, India was faced with an economic slowdown. Numerous projects had come to a grinding halt. 189 languishing projects. 1.5 lakh crores worth of projects stuck. Thousands of crores stuck in disputes. Rampant procedural delays. Cost overruns due to delays. Investment logjam. Progress cannot ride on bad roads. And then, after a decade of despair and decay,
मैं नरेंद्र दामोदर दास मोदी ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि
A new era begins.
रास्तों का नेटवर्क जब बनता है तो विकास को वो गति देता है. हमारे शरीर में भी रक्त पहुंचाने के लिए जैसे धमनी होती हैं, नसें होती हैं, जिसके माध्यम से रक्त चालन होता है और जीवन गति पाता है, उसी प्रकार से रास्ते राष्ट्र के जीवन में धमनी का काम करते हैं, जो विकास को सुदूर इलाकों में पहुंचाने का काम करते हैं.
रोड से प्रॉस्पेरिटी आती है, विकास होता है. रोड सेक्टर अगर खड़ा होगा तो समाज और देश आगे ही जाएगा, इसमें कोई दुमत नहीं.
Under the able guidance of Shri Nitin Gadkari, Minister of Road Transport and Highways, the following initiatives have been taken. In the last 100 days, 1500 kilometers of new highways have been awarded. During the same period, about 1000 kilometers of new highways have been constructed and 350 kilometers have been strengthened, and new expressways are being fast-tracked. Meanwhile, projects are being taken with government funds on EPC mode to keep the sector moving. Policy paralysis of the UPA regime is being reversed by unshackling systems and processes. Decision making has been simplified, decentralized, and made faster by removing unnecessary layers. More financial powers have been delegated to the ministry for fast-tracking projects. Regulatory clearances from Environment and Forest Ministry have been simplified to cut delays. Outstanding issues with Ministry of Railways and Defence have been resolved. Dispute resolution is being fast-tracked. New materials and construction technologies are being introduced. To address last-mile connectivity and reduction of human drudgery, eco-friendly e-rickshaws are being promoted. Interministerial coordination has improved by forming an infrastructure group headed by Shri Nitin Gadkari. Investor confidence is being built. Extensive consultation with stakeholders is taking place. The target is to award 8,500 kilometers and construct 6,300 kilometers this year. Shri Nitin Gadkari has set an ambitious target of building 30 kilometers of road per day. The ministry intends to make road safety a social movement in partnership with schools, universities and civil society to promote safe driving and good pedestrian habits. A new road safety and traffic management board is being constituted. A new Motor Vehicle Act is on the anvil. Adequate infrastructure and systems are being created to provide immediate emergency care within the golden hour for road accident victims. We are ensuring extensive use of information technology to provide safety and convenience to road users by way of electronic tolling, toll information system, CCTV cameras, automatic counting and classification of vehicles. We at the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways are committed to building a new India, and this journey has begun. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas.